Welcome back to our Wudang Online Academy class. Today we practice Qigong outside because of the coronavirus. Welcome to this special series. Yes, you can follow this series at home or also go outside, okay? We should practice all these exercises, of course, outside. If you can, try to go outside and do your movements. So you can strengthen your immune system with these Qigong exercises, okay? And they will help you to stay healthy. So today's topic is the snake form. A snake form is very important for all kind of things, okay? You will strengthen your posture, the digestion will be stronger, yes? You will also improve how you absorb energy from the food, and this way you also strengthen yourself and you can improve yourself. The most important part about the snake movement is how to breathe and how you stay at your posture. When you keep the breathing consistent and smoothly, yes, you try smooth breathing, do not push the breathing, you can enjoy these low postures, okay? Otherwise the breathing will be very flat and very insecure, and you will not have the oxygen that you need, so you will not have the qi you need for doing these postures, okay? So first of all, if you want to improve in this snake posture, focus on the breathing, then try to improve your posture, and then try to follow me step by step with these movements, okay? So now let's look at the posture. We go into gombu. The gombu posture. Often mistake is that you turn the hip forward, yes? Do not do this, yes? Because you will close your hip joint here, yes? We don't want to close. You want to open, yes? So open, yes? So the hip look here, okay? And the hip looking here, the upper body also look here, yes? And you stay at this kind of posture, okay? Now you try to be soft and the heel stay fixed, yeah? Here is soft. And you try breathing, fluid, okay? And the hand stretching, the hand and the leg stretching outside same time, yeah? You try to be longer, yeah? And then you keep the breathing and you keep the posture. So how do we start from the to the snake posture, okay? First, we go to the basic posture again. You breathe in. You turn around 90 degrees to shibu. Yes, from the shibu, you step wide. When you step wide, you go into gombu. Lower leg is straight, okay? From the gombu, you go into pubu. Yes? Now we are at the pubu posture. Try the upper body straight and the heel connected to the ground. If you cannot do it, try to improve your pubu. The pubu should be a kind of resting posture in between the sections of doing the snake form. Now you should go with the hip, yes? The hip should go forward. Look, hip go forward, you're coming here and you're going to gombu and you're stretching the left arm. You open the hip and the right hand goes over your head and you stay in this posture. Now focus on the breathing. You can feel the breathing here, soft, slowly. So, pubu, we're coming here into pubu posture. Try to rest again. And we go again. Gombu. Open the hip. And we go here. Stretch the arms longer. So, pubu, and you stay again pubu posture, okay? This full sequence, we should practice 3 times each side. So, now let me show you the sequence from the position, the same position as the students would see me in class, okay? Try to follow my movements and try to follow the rhythm. Now we do the full sequence. So. 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 Hope you enjoyed this class. The snake posture is very important, so please keep doing it frequently. If you have questions or feedback, please leave it in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and see you soon for more. Goodbye.